Hello everyone, my name is Nathan, and today it's time for another episode of Oxygen Not Included in the Ultimate Base 2.0. There has been an update that actually changed a few things with the possibilities of the world generation. First and foremost, you now have access to the big starting asteroids again from the base game. So if you want to go with a mega base, that is now an option again. And I believe there also has been a new cluster added to the game that we now don't have access to, but I don't think it's that much of an issue just yet. So I definitely don't want to restart all of this again. But it might very well be that the seed doesn't work anymore, so you will not get the same asteroid as I do. Anyhow, the update also added a few things in the research department, which now means I'm left with more interstellar research! No! But this was extremely annoying. Fortunately enough, I could prevent them from taking apart the entirety of the spaceship. It still means we're kind of back to square one with that. Anyhow, apart from progressing in this world as well as the second planetoid, what I would like to do today is take advantage of two of the volcanoes we have here in order to start collecting igneous rock. I do not want to feed all my granite to the hatchlings, and we already have a lot of igneous rock, but we can definitely do better. We have two volcanoes that are pretty nearby each other, so I think we're gonna take advantage of that, and what I would like to see is a nifty system. Anyways, let's get started with that. What I would like to see is the volcano protected with a layer of insulated ceramic tiles. Then it would be great to have a little bit of an overhang, so we will be coming this way. That means the lava or magma is gonna flow into this direction. And then I want it to staircase down all the way to the second volcano. So if we go ahead and actually plan this out, let's see how many tiles that would be. This would be 11 tiles, which is too much for the magma. So in theory, what we want to see is a little bit of magma travel this way before we drop down to this level, and then it can freely flow. But magma is going to stop after 10 or so tiles. No matter how much magma you have, it's not gonna continue flowing further. So yeah, I wanna make sure we can actually reach all of this in order to build it. And it would be great to see some focus on that, since this is gonna be today's project. We're also going to dig out the second volcano. We will have to analyze them both and build the entire contraption before they explode. So I want to build around them first before we do any crazy things. The next thing I would like to see is the magma flowing into this direction. Actually, let's keep this on the same level. So this is going to flow into this direction. So we have to count approximately 10 tiles or so. On the other side, it would be nice to be a little more specific about this. If I drop it down here, then this is the first tile, and we can assume the magma is gonna flow 10 tiles into this direction. So this right here would be the 10th tile, where I want to start converting everything to igneous rock. We will then have to transfer the heat somewhere upstairs in order to get rid of it through a steam turbine, before we can pick up the igneous rock and effectively cool it down. Admittedly, this is a little bit close to the edge. This is not going to be comfortable to build. Let's say we're picking up the heat on this tile and then transfer it upwards a little bit. Actually, that might be possible. So that means to transfer the heat, we would want a steel tile here. Then maybe a couple of steel tiles all the way up here. Then we would add a mechanized door, also made out of steel, right there, in order to transfer the heat upwards into the steam chamber. Then we also want to protect this with ceramic, so we don't accidentally transfer the heat if we don't need to. And I can have a elongated steam chamber. Actually, let's see, this will probably result in something like that. We transfer the heat, and here is the heat stopping mechanism in order to catch up with the heat reduction. The next 10 or so tiles could be the steam chamber. Let me see, do I have more ceramic? I need more ceramic! No problem, we're actually still crafting a little bit. Maybe we can unpause the game, get started with that already. And then I guess somehow we have to make sure we can reach everything. And this would all have to be hollowed out. But let me keep one layer in place so we can easily build everything. One important thing is going to be that we have a vacuum for the most part, especially wherever we do have the magma flowing. And then actually another thing we have to consider is how to transport the item upwards. That is gonna be one of the biggest issues. I mean, we can have like an auto sweeper here that is able to reach this tile. But as soon as we have that, we also need a cooling solution. we are back at cycle 666. Just wanted to point that out, and I took myself the liberty of finishing the layout at least. We still have to add all the contraptions, analyze the volcano, so nothing too specific yet. All I made sure is I completely filled out everything so that I can make a vacuum using this gas pump very easily, and they now have access through a transit tube point. The transit tube itself should never overheat in a vacuum, however the steam turbines will, which is why we have a bottle emptier here where we're gonna set up a liquid layer to cool down the steam turbines. Now all of this is already a vacuum, so I can go ahead and take this apart again, that's good. And we then basically want to make our way inside of here, take everything apart again. I also want to make my way down here, actually. And we're going to have to do that through the means of a ladder. Same thing here on the other side. I would like to ladder all the way down. This ladder here will remain in place. However, everything else I will have to patch up. But I do not want to uncover the volcano just yet. It could end all of our efforts. But there we go. Let's take all of this apart and get it hollowed out again. I then also have a little bit of time to clean up the resources. Maybe we can also already bring the liquid. Right now I do have a little bit of oil that actually seems to be enough for my purposes, and I can also pick it up using the pitcher pump. So oil it is going to be. Enable auto bottle. Let's bring one bottle over here. I want to make sure I build this ladder out of obsidian so it actually can withstand the heat of the magma. We're then taking apart the rest of this contraption as well. This is going to be the chamber with the magma and the auto sweeper. On the top right here, we're going to have our steam chamber, and I made sure we have some iron metal tiles all across to preferably evenly distribute the heat. And I guess at this point, we already want to go ahead and pick up all these materials so we don't have to do it later on. To do the automation for the mechanized airlock, I want to use some steel automation wire, but just in this spot, and then we can switch to normal iron for the rest. All the tiles here on the top should never heat up more than around 250 or so degrees. However, these tiles right here, they could get up to 1500 degrees if we are unlucky. So I definitely want to make sure we have this under control. The automation wire I want to run to approximately here, in the center of the room, a little bit towards the right. Next up, the most important part, we're gonna need an airflow tile, but we first have to figure out where we can set up the auto sweeper so it's still capable of reaching this tile. And it seems as though I can definitely have it somewhere here. Maybe this is not a bad spot. And then we would want an airflow tile, and with this airflow tile we should still be able to reach the point down here. Not because it's an airflow tile, but because we can go in a diagonal direction. The door we're gonna control with a thermosensor. This should go directly in here, and it's gonna measure the temperature of the steam room in order to determine if we are ready to heat up the steam room more. Right now in the beginning I wanna make sure the door is always open so no accidents happen. And of course, whenever the door closes, that's when we can transfer the heat. Now I'm going to need to drop a liquid on top of this airflow tile. That is going to be important. So we will have to dig our way in here and then possibly set up another bottle emptier. I hope I still have some oil left. Yes, indeed I do. We're just going to need a couple of grams, just a little drop basically. Next up, we can already think about the thermo aqua tuner that is going to cool down the auto sweeper as well as the two steam turbines. I want this guy to be on the left side, more or less. And of course, we're gonna go with the usual setup. We want a liquid pipe thermosensor. Gonna build this out of iron, and we also wanna hook it up directly with the automation wire. Now, there's gonna be one little problem with the power. I need to wire the power through here. So I will have to do this at the very end, when we uncover the volcano. Let's also go ahead and set up the pipes. We're gonna use igneous rock for that. So whenever we are above a certain temperature, we wanna run it through the aqua tuner, and then it should go ahead and start cooling down a few things. If the liquid is cool enough already, we can go directly down, and then we need to join these two lines together. Now I kind of wanna make sure the bypass has the priority, so I'm gonna use a bridge in this direction. That means the liquid coming from the aqua tuner itself doesn't have the priority. If we do it otherwise and for some reason there is a clogging up situation going on, we might see liquid traveling through the aqua tuner that isn't supposed to. However, usually it should totally add up without any issues. We're then gonna use an iron pipe down here in this spot, and then we wanna continue once again with insulated piping. I believe in this case I just wanna go back up over and over like so, and then we're gonna do two more cooling radiant pipes for each of the steam turbines. So right here in the center there's gonna be the radiant pipe. And of course at the end of the spiel we're just gonna go back into the loop, easy as that. As for the items that are being picked up, obviously we will also have to ship them somewhere into a conveyor loader, which we also have to cool down. This does have an overheat temperature. So we want to be slightly careful with that. Yeah, it doesn't look like I can add it on this side, so we're gonna add it right here on the other side, which basically means we want liquid spread across the entire section here. That also means we might want to change this up. I mean, technically, if we have the liquid spread across the entire section here, this one single radiant pipe should take care of the entirety of the liquid. So I'm just gonna keep it at that for now. Since we're going to have a vacuum everywhere around here, it will not be a problem to exchange one of these tiles with a conductive join plate, for instance this guy. Or we could actually also do it at the bottom. I think this might be more ergonomical. I'm gonna grab the wire and bring this over, and right here this is a room I will not be able to enter again, so heavy watt conductive wire it should be. Oh, hold on, that reminds me, we will also have to build the railing. I need to build this at a higher priority because I want it... Hold the phone. Yeah, I want it to go up into the insulated layer first. Hold the phone, we could actually take advantage of the layer here at the bottom. The basic goal is to use the items that are still over 1000 degrees hot and lead it through the steam room in order to cool down to a chilly 200 or so degrees. And in order to do so, we will have to take on a little journey, just wiggle around the room somewhere, and then at some point we want to check the temperature, maybe at this spot. So we need a conveyor rail thermo sensor that we're gonna place right there. It would be convenient to have this one block further down, so I can set up a shutoff, a conveyor shutoff. The conveyor shutoff requires power, and it might have an overheat temperature. I wonder. It doesn't show here. I'm gonna build it out of steel, because usually the conveyor shutoffs, they do have an overheat temperature, and I don't want to risk anything. But I'm gonna place that guy, let's see, actually like so. Yeah, so never mind, the thermo sensor still goes up there. We're gonna connect this through a wire, and then, of course, we need the railing to go through here. If we still have too hot material going on, then we wanna continue further down, and actually we wanna go into this line. That also means we want to make sure these materials have priority. So if we go ahead and set up a conveyor bridge like so, then the items coming from down below will not have priority. If the igneous rock is cold enough for the next stage, the next cooling down phase, then we want to bring them somewhere. Maybe we're just gonna go through here and place them next to our transit tube for the time being, so there's gonna be a conveyor chute like so. Alrighty, I took myself the liberty of finishing what we already planned out previously. The only addition that I added is of course the exhaust pipe of the steam generators that goes directly back into the steam room. And hold the phone, there are two things that I forgot, namely we wanna close this room completely off, but also I'm gonna need to re-add my bottle emptier to fill the room up with the initial layer of water. So a little bit of water for me, enable auto bottle, and we're gonna, I don't know, add at least 200 or so kilogram per tile. But so far so good. Of course I'm gonna explain the whole procedure once again when it is in motion. Maybe something we can already set up are the temperature gauges. We will be using either polluted water or salt water. We could actually fill this up with salt water. It has the same properties. So every time we are above 0 degrees, we wanna cool down the liquid so it gets down to minus 14 degrees. However, the materials, whenever we are above 250 degrees, I want to send it back through the loop, but after that, they can exit. I'm not going to do this thermosensor just yet, because I want the mechanized door to be open until we are ready. Another thing we can do is set this conveyor loader to take the igneous rock. So that would be right here. Now let me actually see, we need to get the initial water or polluted water in the joint. Oh, actually we have a mix of brine and salt water, let me see which one is which. Yeah, we have a little bit more brine in the joint. Gonna set up a little pump here and power this through that. Gonna have a simple system to get down there. Oh man, this is going to be a long pipe. But no problem, we just make our way down and go over. This is gonna be disassembled anyways after we're done with it. All we want to do is initially fill up this loop once, so they can already start working on that project. To be sure nothing goes wrong, I added a little liquid filter, filtering out the brine from the rest. Okay, wonderful. We now have approximately 200 kilograms of water per tile. That should be enough. I'm gonna wait for this bottle to drain, and then we can remove everything and close this room off. There we go. Brine is incoming. We're gonna fill up this loop. Now, I don't want to fill it quite up completely. Oh, and I just discovered a fatal flaw. This cannot go like this. What we want is to move this over. This is a nasty mistake. But of course, we want to prevent things going into the aqua tuner twice. So we will have to add this bridge, which means I'm gonna need entrance to this once again. Maybe take apart this tile to be able to build everything. There we go, that should already be good. Mary, you can also build this tile back. No harm, no foul. Now we still have the same priorities, but the direction of the flow of the bypass is also guaranteed. That means I can go ahead and hook everything up again and see how the loop is filling up now. As soon as the liquid is below the 0 degrees temperature, it's gonna go through the bypass exclusively, and that's when I stop the filling up of the loop. Yeah, actually, this looks good. This should allow the liquid to flow almost without interruptions. And we should already see the effects right here. We can cool this down, and we will also be able to cool down the steam turbines gradually. I'm just gonna flip this bridge in order to be able to bring the liquid all back again, and we don't need this anymore. Wonderful, I actually like it. Let's close off this room now, and then we're basically ready to dig up the volcanoes. Why the heck not? And then we basically want to act as quickly as possible. First of all, digging this up. Second of all, we want to also priority 9 this. At some point, I will have to exchange the wiring here, which is not good. I should have built this out of the heavy walk conductive version right away. So we will have to do that now as soon as possible. I'm gonna do it up to this point. The rest I can do later, no problem. The minor volcano here is idle. That's a good sign. I already targeted it for analysis. We also want to do a cleanup. And as you can see, Gene is already analyzing it. The eruption period of the minor volcano is a little bit concerning. Only 67 seconds every 9,300 seconds. That's crazy. You can also see I added drywall everywhere. The lower two tiles here I did with obsidian, so we have a higher overheat temperature. Okay, there we go. Idle erupts in 8.5 cycles. Wonderful. This is almost perfect, I would say. We now have power for the auto sweeper and the conveyor loader. We have the temperatures regulated. That means I'm gonna go ahead and open up the other volcano right away so we can analyze it as well. There it is. It is actually also dormant. Analyze priority 9, please. So we were quite lucky in that regard. Yeah, I guess let's just wait for one of the volcanoes to erupt and see what happens there. So maybe we can make an informed decision whether or not it's working. Alrighty, the moment of truth has arrived. This volcano is about to erupt. This guy right here is still gonna take a couple of cycles, 8 to be quite exact. Let's see how this goes. I had to go back into the room once again to exchange the aqua tuner with a steel version. Totally build it out of copper. What you gonna do? 1.5 in-game minutes for this guy to erupt now. I also exchanged the 3 cables here in the background with steel because I'm not too sure whether or not the volcano is going to be capable of heating them up, and we do have enough steel right now. Come on, erupting in 3, 2, 1, go! There we are! And of course, there will be a little bit of initial igneous rock coming up, but it should liquefy soon enough again. And we can now see this is making its way forward. Looks like the cables on the top wouldn't have been affected by that. So it is actually spawning right here at the bottom. And now we just need to wait for it to gradually progress. This could be a problem. This thing just changed from oil to petroleum because it was heated up to 400 degrees. This definitely could pose a problem. So what I want to do is remove the filters from this conveyor loader. But yeah, that is actually something I haven't quite considered. I now have to go back one cycle because I did not consider this. Good thing I just made a save game before that. But this is still going to be an issue because the freeze point is 1400 degrees of the igneous rock. Oh dear, actually not sure we can fix this easily. However, one thing we might be able to do now is set this to above 200 degrees. Because if we are above the 200 degrees, we want to open up the door, and this is where the signal goes. You see, the biggest problem is that we only have a very tiny amount of oil in here. If we were to fill up the entire tile, we would do better, but then the auto sweeper cannot reach everything again. So we are a little bit in a pickle here. Anyways, let's see this happen again. Volcano is erupting, and then hopefully we can see this flow all the way over to the steel tiles. Okay, I observed this for a little while. I had to add another steel tile right here because even though the magma is going all the way to this tile, the igneous rock is dropping in this one. So I wanted to make sure the igneous rock is still capable of transferring some heat. Now we still have to deal with the heat problem, and unfortunately the igneous rock is not transferring the heat quickly enough. So I don't want to wait for it to cool down, I want to bring it into the system as immediately as possible. If I knew this before, I would probably have made the minor volcano a steam room altogether, but I think we have other possibilities now, so we can still go with the system we have set up. The first thing I want to go ahead and do is pump out the steam room right here, and I want to make sure we kind of collect the water, maybe here on the top. This also means I don't want the water to actually go back into the steam room anymore. It should be dumped right here on the top. We cannot completely get rid of the entirety of the steam, but most of it, so it's just a couple of grams left that we then can sweep up at some point. However, in order to make the new system work, what I would like to do is feed the conveyor loader diagonally through the flooring. And I believe this is possible, at least I did some testing. However, this means we now actually have to get up here, deconstruct a couple of these tiles. This here is the most important one that we want to deconstruct, and I'm gonna make sure this is all high priority. Okay, Ren is taking care of the problem. I think I want him to move upwards immediately, so he's gonna do his job. Ah, there we go, he actually does it on his own. It looks as though the oil has disappeared, but it is actually still here. That's just an effect of the airflow tile. Now that that has happened, we should be able to replace these two tiles. Now Frankie decided to bring his own ceramic, which is not what I want. I want him to drop it right there and then build it using the ceramic that's already placed there. And there we go, wonderful. That worked perfectly. We should be able to hook this up now and pump everything out. Just like that, and eventually we can get rid of the entire thing. There's a little trick you can do. If you mop up with a low priority so nobody ever does it in time, there can be as much liquid as you want in the end when you prioritize it again. But there we go. Now we are essentially just waiting for most of the water or steam to be pumped out in the form of water, and that means we have a little bit of time to seal off the room. I do not want any steam to go into this area here, so we want to make sure this doesn't happen. Oh, one thing I totally forgot. Of course, we need to take apart the conveyor loader, and there's also one rail piece I want to take apart right there. And I'm gonna make sure we pick up most of the stuff, even though it's dropping in lava. We do have a little bit of heat capacity in our storage area with the water pool. And it shouldn't be too bad with just a couple of kilograms of items. We're down to 40 kilograms of water. Maybe another thing we should already take care of is fresh water. So we're gonna grab that from our existing water pipe. That's unfortunately all the way up here. I forgot my mafic wall here. I want it. I need it. There we go, that's what I'm talking about. Replace these ceramic tiles as well, Gene, please. Go down before you do that. No, that's a bad idea. You should move down to the ladder. No, what? No. If you get stuck now, I'm gonna be really mad. Okay. And you can see there's just a tiny amount of steam left, so I definitely want to make sure this doesn't go down below. But now we have this charm plate in the way. That means I should be able to make my way in here and fix a couple of things. Set up the conveyor loader in a way so that the auto sweeper is able to reach it. There, and we can see the steam is immediately going around the place. Okay then, piece of mafic rock, but more importantly, the conveyor loader made out of steel. I'm gonna place that guy right here, and we want to make sure it actually goes down so we can still take the same pathing. Of course, if I knew this in the beginning, I would have routed it a little bit differently. So it's still gonna go around here, have the same priorities. All we need to do is add another bridge that is going over the conveyor loader like so. And this should theoretically be reachable. And before I forget, this will require some power, of course, but that looks like it's a convenient situation. Now, you might think it is a problem because we have the metal tile here without any protection. However, since this is always going to be a vacuum, if everything goes right, it still cannot transfer the heat. Okay, we were not fast enough, some overheat damage. I'm just taking apart the aqua tuner until we have this fixed. Okay, we're almost done with the piping. I think I can risk putting in the aqua tuner again. It's gonna be at 45 degrees initially. Gene is actually doing the honors, and then we can go ahead and close this off again. And we should be ready to refill the steam room with water. That's what I'm talking about. Now, please, are you done with the pipes? Almost? Oh my gosh, you have to speed this up. And will you look at that? It actually worked, because it was so little steam, it just disappeared. A couple more pipes to go, and water should theoretically flow. Let me see this. Oh yes. Maybe at this point we can already start cutting off the pipe. This should be enough water to get this filled up. So I'm gonna deconstruct the liquid bridge already. If we have a little bit too much steam in there, it doesn't really matter. Too little is a bigger problem. Okay, let's reconnect this again, and water should be flowing in. Yeah, directly converting into steam again. And it's now slowly but surely gonna fill up again. Let's make sure this actually happened here. Are we gonna have enough water? I mean, I feel like 20 kilograms is the minimum for a room like this. Yeah, I think I stopped this prematurely. We're gonna reconnect this and add some more water. We now have plenty of water in here. I'm happy. Let's activate the system. We just need to sweep all. Wait a second. Ah, of course. The signal switch. Come on. Yes. What do we have here? Sour gas. Oh no. This is so weird. I mean, the auto sweeper remains cool, as you can see. But as soon as it picks up the item, for some reason, this did count as heating up the oil. So maybe the centerpiece of the auto sweeper should not be submerged in liquid. Only this piece here. So we are still touching. I don't know. I mean, the question is the sour gas gonna pose a problem to us? I guess eventually it might. On the other side, we're now getting the igneous rock as I wanted originally. It basically just made its loop until it reached a certain temperature. This one here is still 800 degrees, for instance, but it is cooling down. And as long as it hasn't cooled down completely to 250 degrees, it's not gonna go anywhere. And this is also gonna give us some additional power. I mean, I do not want to leave the sour gas in here just for efficiency reasons. Otherwise, we will have to cool down a lot more than is really necessary. I want to do one more test with the liquid only being here and swept up in this place. Maybe then this is not going to overheat anymore. And it would be the ideal solution. Alright guys, I'm back and I think we finally did it. We now reduced the amount of oil we have to two spots right here. There's just 300 grams of it. But it is not touching the center of the auto sweeper, and this is exactly what we needed to achieve. During the building process, most of the magma actually got converted into igneous rock. I swept everything up to this point, and now the rest we can give to the auto sweeper. So if we go ahead and actually enable this, this should now work without any overheating, and we can even see the oil keeps the stable temperature and so does the auto sweeper. This is absolutely amazing. I love it. I mean, now with all the changes, it obviously isn't the most compact design I could have gone for, but this seems pretty secure at this point. So we have the initial mechanism to cool down the magma to a certain point, and then the auto sweeper is gonna take care of the rest, just filling up the conveyor loader, which should also not overheat because it is now inside of the steam room. Okay, I'm so happy this is actually working out now. And look at that, the cooling loop doesn't even have too much to do. Right, I would say at this point we can wrap up the episode. This should now be a working system, not as compact as I would have liked it. And of course, maybe at certain points it's gonna be a little bit toasty in here, admittedly. However, overall we should be fine. We still have the option to actually make another steam turbine if we really need to. But it looks as though we're not getting dangerously close to a limit here. I mean, right now we did have more igneous rock than we usually have to deal with in the steam room anyways. And look at that, it's already cooling down again. Wonderful! With that out of the way, let's wrap it up. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a great time and see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.